from T1 is executed, then CPU goes to T2 to execute the instruction from T2 transaction. Then again it comes back to execute transaction T1, and then again goes to transaction T2. This process goes until all the instructions from T1 and T2 gets completed. So when both transactions run parallelly, such schedule is called as concurrent schedule. So this is an example of a concurrent schedule. This particular schedule does not give our database in a consistent set. When you check for the balances of summer balance of account A and account B, initially it will show you 3000 rupees, but after performing everything, after performing schedule number 4, you will find the sum of balance of A plus B does not match. That's why we can say that this schedule number 4 does not give your database in a consistent state. We have 10 minutes remaining. We will try to complete it. Perform it for schedule number 4. You can also do that. Simultaneously check schedule 4 for consistency. Again, you have to consider the same initial balances on before doing anything on from schedule number 4. So initial balances of I'm writing here. Consider the initial balance of account A as 1000 rupees and account B as 2000 rupees. In transaction T1, we are now here in transaction T1. We perform relay operation. So when you perform relay A operation in transaction T1, you will get balance of account A as 1000 rupees. When you subtract 50 from it, it goes to 1000 minus 50 and total value is 950 rupees. But it is not updated, because if you see, the instruction is not there here, right? A operation is not here. After performing A equal to A minus 50, we are directly shifting to account this transaction T2. There we are performing relay operation, right? So when you go to in transaction T2, when you perform read A operation here, you will get 1000 as the balance, because the balance was not updated. There was no write A operation after this statement in the schedule, right? So here when you go, it will show you the balance of account A in transaction T2 as 1000 rupees. On that, the next statement we are executing, that is find 10% amount of this particular balance, subtract it from account A, and then you perform write A operation. Let us do that. Here temp equal to temp into point in. So it is 1000 into 0.10, and it is 100 rupees in temporary variable. Then subtract it from the account A by this statement A equal to A minus 10. So 1000 minus 100, it goes to 900. Then perform write A operation. So this is the updated balance in account A now. So we executed all the statements. So now there is another statement in T2, that is read B. So here we are performing read B in transition T. What it is going to give you, it is 2000 rupees initial balance. Then after this line, we are again going back to transaction T1. Means after reading the account balance of B in transaction T2, we are again shifted to transaction T1 to complete the transaction T1. So what is the next statement here in transaction T1? Write A operation. Can anybody tell me what would be the balance in the account A when I perform write A operation in transaction T1? Let us check who gives the correct answer. What would be the balance in account A when I perform write A operation in transaction T1? this particular line. You can write your answer in the chat box. What would be the balance in account A after performing write A operation from transaction T1? Okay. Shreya is saying it is 950 rupees. Let us see. Here we performed this, correct? It was temporarily stored 950 rupees in account A, but in between transaction T2 updated the account A. So actually account A's balance is only 900 rupees. From that 50 rupees get deducted. So it would be 850 rupees. That 50 will be deducted from this amount, right? If you take the example of joint account of husband and wife, I have given you this example in previous lectures also. If someone withdraws 1000 rupees and later on husband withdraws 2000 rupees, on updated sheet you will get the updated balance, right? The same if you apply here. Then what will happen? Now we are going to transaction T1. To perform the remaining statements of transaction T1, let us see now. In transaction T1, we are going to perform the next statement, that is a write A operation here. So what would be the balance here? It will subtract 50 rupees from the updated balance of account A. So updated balance in account A is 900 rupees. If you subtract here 50, it goes to 855. Then we have another statement, that is read B, then add 50 rupees into it and then write B. I'll do that here. Read B now, read B operation on account B. What is the updated balance in account B? It is 2000. So it will show you 2000 again. Yeah. Then B equals to B plus 50 rupees. That goes to 2000 plus 50. That is 2050 rupees. So when I do write B operation, it gets updated into the balances of account B, which is 2050 rupees in account B. We have covered all these statements from transaction T1. Now we'll go to transaction T2. Right? So what will happen here in transaction T2? It will take the updated balance of account B, no matter who, which instruction, which transaction has updated that particular account. We have to take the updated balance. So what is the updated balance right now? It is 2050 in account B. Let us go into transaction T2. In transaction T2, B equal to B plus 10. So this value goes to updated balance in account T2 is 2050 plus temporary value. What is the value of temp? It was 100 rupees. It was 100 rupees. You can check it here. I'll add that. So this will go to 2150 rupees. And then we have another statement, right? B operation in transaction T2. You can check it here. Last statement of the schedule 2. Schedule number 4 is write B operation here. So write B, when you do that, it gets updated into the account B's balance. So that is 2150. Let us check now. After performing T1, let us check for A plus B. What was the value in account A? Let's check for a write A operation in account A. It is 855. Okay, so I'll put 855 here plus write B operation in account A. write B operation in account A, say in transaction T1. Write B operation in transaction T1 is 2050. Add it here and calculate 2050 plus 855, and the total is 2905. 2905. So before performing the transaction, it was 3000. Right now, it is showing me that after performing T1, it's 2905. They are not matching. Balance are not matching. Let us check for transaction T2 after performing. Transaction T2, the update balance in account A plus update balance in account B is now, if you see, write B operation in write A operation in account, transaction T2. Let us check in transaction T2, write A operation. It is 900 rupees, right? And write B operation in transaction T2. So here I am going to write 900 plus. Go for write B operation in transaction T2. Write B operation in transaction T2. The update balance is 2150. 2150. Add it. 900 rupees plus 2150. And the total goes to 3050. 3050. We check for all the possibilities of transaction T1 and T2 for consistency. And in this schedule number 4, the balances of sum of balance of account A and account B before and after are not matching. That's why we can say that the schedule, the transactions T1 and T2 does not hits the database in consistency. So, hence, we can say that the schedule for does not keeps the database in consistent state. So we come to the final conclusion of our schedule number 4. It is not keeping our database in a consistent state. Now let us see the problem statement that was given to us. All the concurrent schedules . Here is the problem statement. This particular statement is false. This is false because schedule number 3 and 4, which were the concurrent schedule, out of that, schedule number 3 kept the database in a consistent state, but the schedule number 4 does not keep the database in a consistent state. So we come to a final conclusion that the statement given to us is false. So what would be the correct statement for all concurrent schedule? Some concurrent schedule keep the database in a consistent state, some may not. Is the database in a consistent state. So this would be the correct statement for concurrent schedules.